What's up guys, Sal here. So the Huawei Mate 20 Pro is gonna be the most powerful device ever. It will feature Kirin 980 chipset, which is a 7 nanometer chipset by the way, which means better efficiency and more power. It has been benchmarked a lot of times in the past and the results were absolutely amazing. As you can see in this AnTuTu benchmark, it clearly dethrones the Galaxy S9 Plus by a huge margin. Seriously, I or you don't need that much of power, but it's just amazing how technology has advanced in the last 70 years. From the first computers to phones a million times more powerful and a thousand times smaller. But I do hope Huawei doesn't forget about software optimization though. People often complain that their optimization sucks, so I hope that doesn't happen this time. Also, I don't really think the Mate 20 should have a notch. If they were able to make a notchless Huawei Mate RS, then why not the next Mate series as well? Also, it's almost guaranteed at this point that the phone will have an in-display fingerprint scanner. The Mate RS already has this technology, and considering that almost every other Android OEM will launch a phone with an in-display fingerprint scanner within a year, it's a no-brainer that Huawei wants to include this technology as well. The Huawei Mate 20 Pro as part of the Mate range is always going to be a larger device, but you might be surprised by just how big. A new rumor suggests the screen size could be of 6.9 inches. Huawei is currently sampling OLED panels of that size from Samsung for use with a smartphone. That would make the Mate 20 Pro far bigger than the Galaxy Note 9 and iPhone 10 Plus, which are rumored to come in at 6.4 inches and 6.5 inches respectively. And while 6.9 inches might sound excessively large, given that it's almost size of a small tablet, don't forget that smartphones have been getting bigger and bigger. I mean, 6 inches phones are common these days and you rarely find a 7 inch tablet. It looks like Huawei is targeting people who want a bigger phone which can act both as a phone and tablet. Also, the Mate 20 Pro will feature minimal bezels, so the overall footprint will probably not that big. With that said, on paper and in the hand, the Mate 10 looks like a limited upgrade, but powerful new internals may make this phone one of the top phones to buy for those who are looking for a device that doesn't stop or slow down. Let me know what you think about this in the comments down below, and I'll see you all tomorrow. Peace out.